Business is something that you have to think. The control is in your own hands. It is not that it is being controlled by others. Job can be controlled by others. If you have good skills, you can empower the entrepreneurship. So how many of you are doing the courses, programs for their personal development? Maybe many of you are doing for their personal development many courses like digital marketing, like graphic designing. So these are some of the primary skills right now that required everybody. These are not the skills that only that you think that you require only. These are the skills required in the corporates, required in the industries, required in the MSMEs, because without these skills, you can't do the marketing of your product or services. So this is one of the example that I'm going to give you, that you have these skills, you have the leverage. You are going to serve the country by your own skills, your professional skills, and that is your participation in the economic development. How to start with this? I have 7 key points for you that how you can develop your skills for the national empowerment, and for the same you have to notify yourself that how you are doing that daily. If you are getting at 3 o'clock and doing something for yourself, that is something that you are doing for the country. Now let us speak about the national empowerment. What the 7 key point that I am going to speak today, I will share my screen with you. So the 7 point that I am going to share with you are our story, what the story that we are writing for ourselves, our mission and vision, how to define the mission and vision for yourself, 7 type of business models that you have to identify, and 7 type of professional skills that you have to identify in this change mechanism, the ecosystem, evolution of the expert. As an expert, what should be your evolution? How you have to identify your key skills, how to build the multiple overflows. Look, everybody is thinking about the income, additional income, or either something that is he can make himself as per his own abilities. So how to build the multiple overflows? Step to solve the fast, how you can solve the fast, the issues, the problems of others. What is the major issue, major problem of the ecosystem right now? The COVID-19 is the major issue right now, that the ministry is even overflowing with the result oriented approach from the youth, that they can, how they can participate to develop a ecosystem, a mechanism where we can do the control of this COVID-19, and we can make the economic downfall a success venture by making our participation. Then how you can do your marketing? If you have a product or a service, how you can make your marketing skills in this? The 6 stages of making your idea into movement. Look, many of us, they have many ideas, but because of the abundance of ideas, maybe we are not able to take the decision. So your strongest emotion should be captured by your strongest idea. If you have strongest emotion to work for the society, that means you should go by that. You should not get under the influence of others. If your strongest emotion to work for the health system, you should go by that. You should not be influenced by the people, those who are earning more. You should be influenced by your own skills. You should capture your own skills, first of all, that as per your own skills, as per your own interest, you should start working on that. Then 5th point is your next action step to scaling fast. How you can scale fast? Then the strategy, then mapping of your idea into a business model or into a professional skill. Then go government handholding. How you can be helped by the government handholding? So these are the 7 points that I am going to discuss today with you. Step by step, we people will move on about these 7 points. The first thing that I would like to tell you is about my books. These are my three books: Masters Can Foresee, Human Source Management with Industrial Application, Empowering Entrepreneurship, Empowering India. Right now, we need more and more people, those who can empower the economy, than the job seekers. Why? Because after this pandemic, after this COVID episode, you will be looking for the job, and it's very tough to have the job in these circumstances. But there will be more of the opportunities, the business opportunities. So how you have to adapt with those business opportunities, today I'm going to tell you about the same. When we talk about the business opportunities, first, as a responsible citizen, we people have to define our mission. Or either, if we are looking for a job, then even we people have to define our mission. The mission should be simple, should be society oriented, and should be focused. Your mission should be segregated as per your vision. Your vision will be bigger, but you have the smaller mission against your vision, so that you can easily achieve your vision. So you have to define your vision first of all. Then it comes to the mission. You have to segregate, you have to do it step by step. You should not think like this. If you want to be a CEO of a company, or either you want to start a business, you should not like start from the thinking like this, that you have to start from the top ladder. You have to start from the very first ladder of the journey, so that you can learn more. If right now you have skill of graphic designing, right now if you have skill of website designing, that means you have adopted those skills to serve the other people. And if you are serving the other people with full dedication, your results will be maximized. So your mission should parallelly attached with the vision, and it should be concentrated, focused, objective-full, right? So this is what that you have to do with this. Then we come to the next level, that how to go with the how you have to find out your niche. Look, everybody is going to speak about that you should go by your own profession. Yes, that is true. But all the experts across the world that we see, they people, what they find out? They find out the niche. They find out their micro niche. Niches, that is their primary interest. Niche, that means their primary skill or primary interest, that you, by which they would like to serve the country. So as a professional link that you have to set up with your niche. So if you have found that you would like to be expert, someday you want to be expert of designing or development, someday you want to be expert of manufacturing, in the manufacturing of PPE kit, right now the PPE kit and all these doctor related equipments are high in demand. So you want to work in the health sector, but in the health sector there are about 65,000 products and services. So you can't say that you can work on the 65,000 altogether. So you have to find your niche. You want to be a graphic designer. If you wish to be a graphic designer, what should be your expertise in graphic designing? Would you like to be expert of logos? Would you like to be expert of website designing, right? If you would like to be a website designing or ERP developer, then you should get yourself expertized on a language. There are many languages in IT sector, like PHP is a language, .NET is a language. Java is a language. So there are many languages. You can't be expert at the same time of all the languages. So you have to identify your niche. If you would like to start up with the website designing, what particular language of expert you would like to be. So this is that how you have to find out the niche. If you would like to work for the women health and wellness, and you would like to advertise about the women health and wellness, so how to find out the niche? In women health and wellness, there can be many niches, but you have to be very, if you would like to be very efficient, you have to find your niche first of all, how you would like to work for the women. Like if I would like to have to work for the women, most of the women on the internet, they are searching for how to get slim and trim. So this is one of the niche of the women health and wellness sector. So in nutshell, what I would like to tell you that first of all, find the niche, then the professional link, that how professionally it is linked, what kind of profession it will serve, how to get into this, then what kind of services you can offer, how efficiently you can offer the services, then the expert mentoring, like the Vidyadhan today, they people have organized this session for you people. This is expert mentoring. You may be even attending all those expert mentoring session by the Vidyadhan itself. Then affordable entry. Look, everybody, what the people are looking for, if I'm going to say that I have to get into a business, I have no money, or either I'm looking for a service like slim and trim service for the woman. So everyone is going to look for a affordable entry. Nowadays, this episode of COVID is going on and the people sitting at home, they would like to learn better from the better people. But their pockets are not deep, so they are looking for the affordable entry. So you can have the affordable entry right now for them. Vidyadhan, the people have created this platform as an affordable entry for the experiencing and the expertising in a particular field. Then you have to clear about the target clients. Your target clients, like you are young, you are smart, you are interactive. You can easily interact with the people and you can even easily target them by giving them the relevant services. It's very tough to sell the Gita, Bhagavad Gita, Ramayana to a person who is 10 or 20 years old. But you can sell the Bhagavad Gita to a person who is above 40 or 50. So this is again a finding out a niche that to whom you have to target. In these days, you have many tools to target the people. You have Google, you have Facebook. So you haven't to worry about. You have to just parallelly interact with the people, people as per their interest, as per their demography, as per their age. So these are the factors that you have to identify. Then you have to remember the secret of every profession. Many times the people, they say, they come to me, I'm imparting the workshops at IIT Bombay and many other premium institutions. They have one question only about themselves, that how to find the secret of business, how to find the secret of the profession that they are doing. So every profession has a secret. But in my book, Master Can Foresee, I have briefed up, I've concised the secret. And secret is in 3S. 3S is a secret strategy for professional upgradation for business management. You have to write up this. This is a very unique strategy. If you would like to do a job, then even this strategy will work for you. If you would like to do business, then even this secret will work for you. So you have to do your boosting with the help of this 3S secret. The first S of this 3S is right structure. Look, these days, the high-end services are being delivered by the IT departments, and service sector is going to be boomed. And it is a service sector is one of the sector that is never going to end up. In manufacturing, if you start a manufacturing plant, after a few years, the technology will demand the upgradation. And that is not easy for the manufacturing sector. But then even the manufacturing sector is the primary sector. Similarly, IT departments, IT and the technology, web technologies are the primary requirement of the system. So you have to find your right structure. If you have found your niche, as I have exemplified you, that you would like to serve, what kind of clients, where you would like to serve, demographically, how you would like to serve. If you have found your niche, as per that example of the woman wellness, health and wellness, then as per that niche, you have to do with the right structure. Once you have done with the right structure of the system, what is the right structure? I will give you an example first of all. Your body, it has a right structure. Your head is planning and strategic development that is being done by your head. Your hands and your legs are for acceleration of the things. So this is the right structure. You enter into a room, in an auditorium, and you find a right structure to be settled there well. So this is the right structure for you. Similarly, once you are going to start a business, you have to find the right structure for your business. Then self-sufficiency. Then you have to make the model self-sufficient. Do your marketing yourself. Don't be dependent upon others. Marketing is something that is the spirit of your business, because this is the front-end approach. If you are going with the front-end approach, you will be making your system, the whole system, workable. It is not back-end approach. Look, everybody is going to do the marketing. If I am going to speak, this is even a way to do the marketing. If I am going to speak my neighbor, that is even a marketing of some of the skills. Anyhow, we are selling something. If we are not working in marketing, then even we are selling our skills. If we are working in graphic designing, website development, then even we people are selling our skills. So marketing and selling is self-sufficiency that you have to come to. Then scalability. For having the scalability, you have to make the other people to join your mission, and those will be the like-minded people. Look, working alone and working in team makes a difference. If you are young, near about 18 or 20, so start working with your friends. Have a team. If you are working in team, that is your power. If you are working alone, that is your innovation. So, working for power, you have to work with others. So scalability will be achieved if you are working in team. First, make the right structure for yourself. Make that system self-sufficient. That is the second S. If you have done these two S, then come to the scalability and start working in a team. Have the like-minded people with you. Find the like-minded people who can promote your business, who can even get promoted by you. Give and take should be there. If we are living in society, we are not giving good qualities, we can't achieve the good productivity. If we are not achieving the good productivity, we can't give the good quality. So achieve the skills, those are highly required by you. Then seven type of business models that you have to identify. What are those seven type of business models? Manufacturing. This is one of the business models where you can work anytime, but to work in the manufacturing field, you have to do with the investment. So you should not worry, ministry is helping to get your investment done. Then retail, small business owners, if you would like to start up the retail business, you can start from home itself. You can even do online retailing by the e-commerce websites. And you can even do the promotion with the help of your IT skills. Then distribution. Distribution of product is something that is highly required. This is the pipeline of the ecosystem. If you don't know the distribution, you can't participate into the ecosystem. So you have to develop the distribution ecosystem. So you can become the distributor of somebody if you would like to be there. Then service. If you are an artist, you are a doctor, that means you can work into the service sector. Then franchisee model. If you have developed a business model like graphic designing and all those works, you might have seen many of the websites like Canva and other. Those the people have developed their website, and after that they are selling only the designs to the other people, where people can come, paste their logo and have an advertisement. So these kind of websites that you can develop for yourself and for others, where the people will come and customize their design as per their requirements easily. Then aggregators. Who are the aggregators? Aggregators are those organizations, those have control of a innovative product or a service. Like Google is an aggregator. Like bulk SMS company, then Tata is an aggregator. So you can, if you think that you would like to be aggregator, it requires the higher investments. So you can't start with the higher investments. In that case, you should develop a freedom business model for yourself. So what is the freedom business model? This is the seventh business model. I have spoken about the six business models where we require the higher investments. So in the starting, we can't do with all those things. Like in manufacturing, retail, distributor, as a distributor, you have to invest. Service, franchisee, aggregator, these are the six kind of business models where you need the higher investments. But in freedom business model, you have to invest your own professional skills. What are the features of freedom business model? It is around yourself. It is not like you have to depend upon others. It is as per your own skills. No one on their payroll. In freedom business model, you are not hiring the people on your payroll, but you are hiring the freelancers. If you are a designer or a developer, you can hire the SEO expert after designing a website. So this is a kind of this is an example. All these tech available online that you have to think, nothing is like this that you have to worry about in this system. You have to just develop your skills of a particular niche. If you have a particular niche you have developed, then byproduct of that niche will come automatically to you. Then empower the same set of minds. You have to empower the same set of minds with the help of this freedom business model. Then if you have done with this, you have developed your professional skills, you have found your niche, then what will happen? Then there will be business growth. You will be finding the relationship. You have to manage the PR with the people, those who are promoting your business, those who are helping you. If you are hiring them on your payroll, then even you have to manage that. But to the freelancers, it is easy to manage. Then your achievement that you are targeting, that is money growth, will happen. But what you have to do to do this all, you have to be very modern and up to date, number one. If I say the modern, that means as per the ecosystem, you have to change yourself. If you are not able to go outside of your home for your safety right now, you have to be with the ecosystem and up to date that what the ecosystem requires and start promoting that. You have to be very young and fresh. You have to be very smart and refined. These qualities that you have to develop for your professional growth and for your business growth even. If you have developed all these qualities, then educate yourself time to time. Go to an education system where you can find the people, those who can educate like-minded people. Then freedom. Find out the freedom that how, with what freedom you can move on in, with this ecosystem. Then find out the money problem of others, not only of yours. Most of the time we people are focused on our money problems, so it is very tough to get the growth. If you are looking at the money problem for others and to start helping them to grow them, you will definitely growing with them. So this is the quality of a businessman. The biggest example of this is Mukesh Ambani, when he has launched in 1991 mobile handset of rupees Reliance. The people have launched a mobile set of 589 rupees. So what the people have done? The people have found the problems of other, that the people, they are not able to afford 10,000 or 15,000 rupees mobile phone. So the people have launched a mobile phone of rupees 589 only. With that, the people served to the carpenters, to the rickshaw pullers, and to all the authorities. So this, that the people have empowered with the help of all this ecosystem. Now listen to yourself. That is most important. Then how to work by yourself? You have to master a few of the skills in your attitude. And those are three pillars of influence for your attitude. One is, if you are a startup, if you are a professional, be authentic. If you know something, straightway tell to your client for whom you are solving a problem that I can it, I can't it. I have to develop it. I have to get the help of the freelancers in this. So be authentic. Whatsoever you have, that is your quality. That is your operational quality. Work on that. Then strategic logic. Give a strategic logic to yourself. Develop a strategy for your own skills. Then develop the empathy for others. Love others, respect others. Frame it in yourself and you will be finding that the people, they are participating with you. So this is all that you have to do for the development of the freedom business model. Once you have found your niche, I will be back with you. And I will be developing your niche as per your professional identity, as per your professional skills. I will be giving you the training programs that how you have to launch your niche into the market. So this is the step-by-step journey that we people will be doing in next. By the next session, I will be giving you the workshop on that how you people have to develop a skill as per your own niche. Stay at home, stay safe. Thank you. I would like to thanks to the Vidyadan for this opportunity and to all of you for participating in this. Take care.